Hurricane Headquarters, sponsored by Entergy.
12 News is your Hurricane Headquarters. Right now, Texas is bracing for Beryl as it travels through the southern Gulf of Mexico with the Gulf Coast in its sights. Good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us. I'm Claydra Rhodes. Now, Tropical Storm Beryl came barreling through the Caribbean and Mexico, leaving behind a trail of destruction. Meteorologist Kerry Cooper joins us now. We're going to bring him in. And Kerry, waters in the Gulf could allow Beryl to begin strengthening later today.
That's right, Claydra. Been watching Beryl, of course, over the last several days. And of course, Beryl hasn't changed much today as far as strength wise. That's very good news. Let's take a look at the Gulf of Mexico now. Beryl, very lopsided. It's still battling some dry air intrusion and also some wind shear. That should improve tomorrow. I still think Beryl will come at least a Category 1 hurricane before making landfall well to our southwest. From Matagorda coming up on Monday morning. Highest winds around 60 miles an hour. Here's the future track. See landfall right around Victoria or southwest of there toward Matagorda as a Cat 1, maybe a Category 2. And that'll be well to our southwest. In fact, we're not even near the cone anymore. So I think we're going to be in pretty good shape here. We'll talk about that, though, coming up in just a moment. Then the remnants move on out into Arkansas and eventually Tennessee as we head toward the middle end of the week. So Beryl's going to be on the move. He's not going to stick around much. Now, here's predicted rainfall totals from Beryl. Notice north of Houston from Interstate 35, 45 westward. That's where the biggest impacts are going to be. I think we're going to average, looks like 1 to 3 inches, maybe some 4-inch rainfall totals in a few spots. Could be some less totals in spots, could be a little bit higher totals in spots. But one thing I want to emphasize, if Beryl comes ashore at Matagorda as a small compact storm, these totals may be less than this. So just keep that in mind. Here's a wind gust future cast we're looking at beginning Monday morning at 7 a.m. ending on Tuesday. Notice most of the winds, gusty winds, stay well out to our west. We're expecting some maybe 30 to 40 mile an hour gusts coming up on and off throughout the day, Monday into Tuesday morning, before things improve Tuesday afternoon. Now, some weather impact alert days coming up. We have those, of course, for late Monday into Tuesday morning. Possibility, anyway, of some heavy rains. What to expect? As we said, some 1 to 3 inch rains possible. Could be a little bit more, could be a little bit less. Once again, if Beryl comes ashore as a small storm that far to our southwest, we may get less than that. That's some heavier totals will be possible, especially in the far western areas. And of course, your 3-day forecast. Weather alert impact days coming up for late Monday into early Tuesday. Then the weather starts to improve by Tuesday afternoon. The rest of the week, we're back to normal summer southeast Texas weather. We'll have the rest of your weather impact forecast coming up a little bit later.
All right. Thank you.